Welcome to a lesson on determining the horizontal and vertical asymptotes of a rational function. A rational function is a function that can be described as a quotient of two polynomials where q of x is not the zero polynomial, or the domain of the rational function would be all the values of x that don't make q of x or the denominator equal to zero. Here's an example of a rational function where the numerator is the polynomial x squared minus 4 and the denominator is the polynomial x squared minus 2x minus 3. And it's often helpful to express a rational function in factored form as we see here. Let's take a look at the graph of this function. So the one thing we should notice right away is that this graph has two vertical asymptotes, here at x equals negative 1 and here at x equals 3. Vertical asymptotes are lines that the graph approaches but never touches. And this graph also has a horizontal asymptote of y equals 1. And a horizontal asymptote is a line that a graph approaches, but it may also cross it, as we see here. One last thing to notice about the domain of this function is, since x equals negative 1 and x equals 3 would make the denominator equal to 0, we must exclude those two values from the domain. Let's take a look at how we're going to determine the equations of the vertical asymptotes. The line x equals a is a vertical asymptote of the graph of the function if a is a zero of the denominator and does not come from a common factor with the numerator. Zeros of the denominator that are also zeros of the numerator result in a hole in the graph, not a vertical asymptote. So for example, if we take a look at this function here, the first thing we want to do is factor both the numerator and denominator. So we'd have x plus 3 times x minus 3. And the denominator would be the factors of positive 6 that add to negative 5. We'd have x minus 2 and x minus 3. Notice there are two values that make the denominator equal to 0. The domain of this function would have to exclude x equals 2 and x equals 3. But these both do not result in vertical asymptotes. Since the 0 x equals 3 is also a 0 of the numerator, there's a hole at x equals 3, not a vertical asymptote. However, x equals 2 is a 0 of the denominator, but not of the numerator, and therefore there is a vertical asymptote at x equals 2. And if x equals a is a vertical asymptote, as x approaches the value of a, f of x or y approaches either positive infinity or negative infinity, meaning the graph will go up indefinitely or down indefinitely as it approaches a vertical asymptote. Now let's talk about horizontal asymptotes. Horizontal asymptotes are horizontal lines that the graph approaches as x approaches either positive infinity or negative infinity. So for horizontal asymptotes, we're going to see how the function behaves as x increases or decreases without bound. One way to help us determine the horizontal asymptotes is to think as the numerator and denominators racing to infinity. If we can determine whether the numerator or denominator wins, will help us determine the equation of the horizontal asymptote. What I mean by that is, if the degree of the numerator is higher than the degree of the denominator, as we see here in this first function, there will not be a horizontal asymptote. The reason there isn't one is because the degree of the numerator is 3 and the degree of the denominator is equal to 1. So as x approaches positive infinity, the numerator is increasing faster and therefore the function value increases without bound. And we can illustrate this pretty quickly with a graphing calculator. I've already typed the function into y1. If we go to our table and then using the table feature, we can see that as x increases, y increases without bound. Here's an illustration of why there's no horizontal asymptote. We can also look at this graphically. If we press the graph key, you can see as we move right along the graph moves up indefinitely, or if we move left, it moves down indefinitely. Therefore, there's no horizontal asymptote. If the degree of the numerator and denominator are equal, the horizontal asymptote will be the ratio of the leading coefficients. So looking at our second example here, our numerator and denominator have degree 1, and the ratio of the leading coefficients would be 2 over 1. Therefore, the equation of the horizontal asymptote is y equals 2. Let's take a look at this on the graphing calculator. I'm going to go ahead and turn off y1 and turn on y2. Let's go to our table. And notice that as x increases, we can see that the y value is approaching the value of positive 2. And we can also take a look at the graph and see that as we move to the right, or as x approaches positive infinity, the y value is approaching positive 2. And if we approach negative infinity, you can see we'd be approaching positive 2 as well. And then lastly, if the degree of the denominator is higher than the degree of the numerator, the horizontal asymptote will be y equals 0. So the numerator here has degree 0, the degree of the denominator is degree 1. As x increases without bound, the numerator stays at 2, the denominator increases without bound, therefore the function value is approaching 0, so y equals 0 is our horizontal asymptote. Let's go back to the calculator one more time. Let's go ahead and turn off y2 and turn on y3. Let's look at the table first. As x increases without bound, we can see the y values are quickly approaching 0. We can see as x approaches positive infinity to the right, the function values approach 0. And they do the same if we approach negative infinity to the left. Let's go and take a look at our examples now. Here we want to determine the vertical and horizontal asymptotes and then graph the function. Notice the numerator and denominator cannot be factored. So for the vertical asymptote, if we set x plus 1 equal to 0, we would have x equals negative 1 as a vertical asymptote. Let's go ahead and sketch that. And then for the horizontal asymptote, the degree of the numerator is 0, the degree of the denominator is 1, therefore our horizontal asymptote would be y equals 0. Or again, you can think of what happens to the function value as x increases without bound. Our numerator stays at 4, our denominator gets larger and larger, so the function values would approach 0. Now these asymptotes make it a lot easier to graph this rational function because we know the pieces of the graph will approach these lines. So let's go ahead and determine a couple of points on this function, and then we should be able to make a nice graph of the function. And we're going to pick values that are close to the vertical asymptote. So we'll select x equals 0 and x equals 1 to the right of the vertical asymptote, and then we'll select x equals negative 2 and x equals negative 3. Well, when x is 0, we'd have 4 divided by 1, that's 4. When x is 1, we'll have 4 divided by 1 plus 1, that'll be 2. When x is negative 2, we'll have 4 divided by negative 1, that'll be negative 4. And then when x is negative 3, we'll have 4 divided by negative 2. Let's go ahead and plot these four points. 0, 4, 1, 2, negative 2, negative 4, and negative 3, negative 2. Notice without these vertical asymptotes, we probably couldn't make a nice graph, but since we do know the function approaches these lines, we can make a pretty good graph with just these four points. It would look something like this. And here's the graph done on some software. Let's take a look at another example. The first step is to factor both the numerator and denominator. X squared would be x times x, and the denominator also has a common factor of x. So even though 0 and 2 are zeros of the denominator, they both do not result in vertical asymptotes. Because x equals 0 is also a 0 of the numerator, there's a hole at x equals 0, and there would be a vertical asymptote at x equals 2. And then for the horizontal asymptote, Since the degree of the denominator is equal to 2, and so is the degree of the numerator, the horizontal asymptote would be the ratio of the leading coefficients, or the horizontal asymptote would be y equals 1. Let's go ahead and sketch our two asymptotes. We have x equals 2, and we have y equals 1. Let's go ahead and select a couple values of x and then determine y. Let's go ahead and select x equals 3 and x equals 1. F of 3 would be 9 divided by 9 minus 6. That would give us 3. When x is equal to 1, we'd have 1 divided by 1 minus 2. That's going to give us negative 1. So we have the point 3, 3, and then we have the point 1, negative 1. And so even though we have two points, we know the graph is going to approach these asymptotes. So we could sketch something like this, and this piece would be approaching these asymptotes. The only thing you have to be careful about is there's supposed to be a hole at x equals 0. So what we should do is go over to our graph at x equals 0 and make sure we have a hole there. And looking at some software, the graph would look like this. I hope you found this helpful.